Hey, it's Lego Jang here with a look at Lego City set number 60017. It's called the flatbed truck, and it actually comes with two vehicles, the truck and a car that it picks up to tow, presumably to a service station. So this is a $20 set. Let's go ahead and open up the box, see what parts are inside, and build it up one bag at a time. And there we have it, the flatbed truck set, all completed. The minifigures consist of a flatbed truck operator here. Very happy, very bright-eyed looking guy, like, oh, wow, your car is broken down. Oh, wow, look at that. I'll just pick it up. All plain on the back, only one face on him. A pretty straightforward, basic city guy. And then here, this is a businesswoman. Obviously your car broke down on the way to work, evidently. Got a little black briefcase there. It's a pretty good looking standard minifigure. And then her car is this relatively expensive looking, fancy looking, a little convertible sports car, I guess, like a luxury convertible drop-top sports car. But you know, I don't really like this car. I'm sorry, I don't. A little bit plain on the looks, not too bad, but a little bit plain, especially on the side, so flat. And then it's the four wide, you know, four lugs wide with these wide fenders and even wider tires. It's almost like it has off-road tires on it, and they really stick out, and I just don't like that style in general. They've done that on a number of ones recently, and I don't approve of it personally. I don't think it's a good look for just a normal, regular street car. I like the round bumper here. I like what they did with the special piece that they use that goes across to create the sides of the hood. I like the little turn side view mirrors, a little bit of a spoiler back here, that's pretty good, but the car on the whole, it's kind of meh for me. And then they do give you a little stoplight, and it's just an add-on fixture that you can add to your little scenes, and that's pretty cool. And here's the main attraction of the set, the flatbed truck itself. This one's pretty cool looking. You know, it looks proper. They think they did a good job of capturing the look of the flatbed service and tow truck. It's got a nice look to it. A little bit of an extended front here, a little extended nose. I like how they built that together with the front end of a car, a little hood piece there. Again, with the round front bumper, got the side view mirrors here, got the nice light bar. Got an ample cabin with a coffee cup there, or mug. It's got the doors open up on either side, and it's got a little wrench over here on the side. Looks really good from this angle. Looks really, really, really good from this angle. Really, really like that. A little bit empty and open if you get all the way down to the ground and look at it from the side here, but not too bad. You could easily put in just another brick or a couple of plates in there. A 2x2 and a 2x3. Stack those up and that'll take care of that. If that bugs you at all, it doesn't really bug me that much, but I really like the look of it from this angle. It's really awesome. And then you've got the action where you can actually move the bed up, angle the bed up, and it has a winch that you can actually crank. So there's a hook on the end here, and this can be pulled out. It's a little bit tight right now, but this can be pulled out, and they expect you to hook this to the front of the car underneath. You can just use the stud like so, and then I guess I'll let it out a little bit more just so you can see how this works out. And then you can just turn with this all the way up. You can turn this and actually pull the car up. Pull the car all the way up. It goes over the little stops. Oops. And there it is. And that will hold it in place. Looks like I may have put the wheel stops in the wrong place. No, looks like it's okay. I just need to let this go back a little bit. There you go. And that's where it's going to hold it. It's kind of hanging off the edge just a little bit, but as long as you keep it hooked on, it'll be okay. The wheel stops aren't really doing all that much if I let this go. It's kind of holding it in there. It's a little bit precarious, but it's holding it in there. I would keep this just tightened up though. And it's a pretty good look. It looks pretty decent with the relative scale. I think that this car looks a little bit large by comparison for the size that the truck should be. And I also think that it hangs off the back just a little bit too much. I wish that it was pushed forward or probably about a half a stud forward, half a lug forward would have been good. But that's kind of nitpicking. I like the truck. I think that the truck itself is really well built. Has some nice little uses of parts and little techniques that they put together to make an easy to build yet pretty realistic looking and very playable little piece. The minifigs are good for just general city building, and then they give you another little thing off to the side just as a bonus. So overall, I like the truck. I like all this. Not a big fan of the car, but fortunately the car wasn't responsible for too many of the pieces of the set, so I think it still ends up being a pretty decent deal. That is the flatbed truck, set number 60017 from Lego City. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.